I try to be a figurehead for the entire movement, because I, whatever happens, I'm still the one who's mostly in the media, and I'm the only real journalist of the movement, which, you know, I'm surprised. I keep telling people, if you want to make your mark, you really need to make it in terms of journalism, because, you know, you can be on Facebook all day long, but one New York Times article is more traffic than an entire year or maybe 10 years of being on Facebook in terms of influence. So I've been telling people that they need to kind of change their methodology. And, you know, I've told all the elder academics about this as well. But you know, I just try to represent it in a balanced way and move it forward. But people need to understand that if you want transhumanism to grow up and be a mainstream movement, it's going to require looking historically at what other movements have done and emulating those movements. So, for example, the environmental movement, which 40 years ago had, you know, a whole 10 people, and they were just a little, you know, Greenpeace people trying to stop nuclear explosions or stop whaling. And then all of a sudden they became a multi-billion person movement that the entire world is focused on, not Greenpeace, but they launched the environmental movement. How can we make transhumanism become a multi-billion person movement? And that requires a whole bunch of different facets, of different strategies, decentralization, people going off in different areas, millions of journalists, even accountants and attorneys and filing lawsuits. And, I mean, there's a big giant machine for it. And so I push people to do all these things, but, you know, transhumanism has grown mostly within the youth, mostly within millennials. And millennials have a tendency to not be able to get the job done at this point, because in fact, a lot of them are quite entitled in America, and they're just kind of like, they just want free money. It's all about basic income for them and all this. And that's great. Don't get me wrong. I mean, I support a lot of these ideas, but in the end of the day, like, making a world-class movement requires 7 days a week, 12 hours a day, work, 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 and not just sitting on Facebook arguing against each other. And I keep telling people this. You know, we have, for example, the presidential candidate right now, the Transhumanist Party. It's, you know, he's getting like virtually no coverage, whereas my candidacy received at this point, you know, almost 100 million views. It was exploding and doing all these different things. And it's all because I led through activism. I did projects that people would notice, and like the coffin bus and whatnot. And in order for transhumanism to move, people have to either be engaged in campaigns, engaged in different kinds of projects. They have to be off the internet and in the real world doing stuff. And that's been a very difficult thing to get transhumanists to do, is to actually engage in activism, because so many of them are young and they think the world is just an Instagram account.